What's this story about in your mind?
Just what it's like to be the most talked about writer in the country, or that that sort of thing.
You're like a nervous guy, huh?
No, I'm okay. How are you?
I'm terrified.
The end of the tour is not a biopic. It doesn't span 30 or 40 years. It's a very small window of time in two men's lives. And with Wallace, it's a few days when he was 34 years old, just after the publishing of Infinite Jest.
I was amazed that someone was going to give me an opportunity like this. People tend to see you the way that they've seen you do other things before. And it really speaks to James Ponsoldt.
I think that writing books is a little bit like raising children, you know? You have to be careful, though. It's okay to take pride in the work, but I think it's bad to want the glory to reflect back on you.
You know, when we were talking about who'd play David Foster Wallace, we talked about everyone under the sun, and I've been a huge fan of Jason since Freaks and Geeks, and I felt this level of empathy and relatability and vulnerability in that character that I feel when I watch very early performances by Henry Fonda or Jack Lemmon or Jimmy Stewart or Tom Hanks, where it's someone that, oh yeah, I would go anywhere with that guy.
Even in Jason's comedy, there is a gravitas, and there's almost a ruefulness, and certainly intelligence.
You know, once I talked to Jason and heard his hopes and fears and anxieties, I realized he was exactly the person to play it.
I think that if there's a sort of sadness for people under 45, it has something to do with pleasure and achievement and entertainment, like a sort of emptiness at the heart of what they thought was going on.
That was my big task in prep, was to tackle Infinite Jest.
I read. I had some friends start a book club, because it's a really tough read, and it's a long read. I mean, reading Infinite Jest really changed my life.
He was communicating really universal ideas. What he is trying to accomplish is this idea of the reader feeling like, hey, that's me. And I didn't even know how to express that I felt that way.
I think if the book is about anything,
yeah,
it's about the question of why.
Right.
Why am I doing it? And what's so American about what I'm doing?
Jason and I didn't meet until the night before we were filming. I think we fell immediately into a dynamic that was dramatically potent and carried this incredible momentum.
David Foster Wallace, he's a man who means so much to so many people. That had to be treated with a real respect, and I felt like the best way to do it was to do it with real love. There's nothing exploitative of approaching a character like, how are we the same?
All I can really do is to try to understand a point of view as much as possible, relate to it as much as I can, and then just be really honest between action and cut.
When I think of this trip, I see David and me in the front seat of his car. He wants something better than he has. I want precisely what he has already.